The title of my talk, What You Have Been Losing. By looking at this title, some of you guys may think, I haven't been losing anything so far, so what is she going to teach about? Well, at first, I had complete no idea about what lessons I should provide to you guys, because I was under a severe pressure when I was first told that I could stand on the stage and talk about presence. When I first transferred to the school, the Korean International School, obviously, in 2015, I was very, very intrigued about TEDxKISHCMC. Because as always, I was a big fan of TEDxKISHCMC. However, I had no idea how to get closer to this talk due to the fact that I was such a fool. Plus, I wandered around like an idiot and ended up looking idiot, and I lost the opportunity to get at least one step closer. Here at this point, I already have lost the chance to make myself better. A year passed by, just passed by, but nothing special. I was recommended to be the speaker of TEDxTalk, and since I'm the type of person who goes straight forward without thinking, I said yes. It was such an honor for me to hold even a slight responsibility in this big event. After that, I shivered a lot, and also, I was so nervous. And I was so ashamed that I had to be so nervous at this event. Imagine standing in front of a number of people, expecting the past quality of information, and I trying to deliver them a few words, despite the fact that I've gone on. I didn't know what to plan, what to say, or rather, what to catch. Do I really have an extremely deeply touching story to provide? But what if I've got non-episodes in my life? My life has been in such an ordinary daily routine, I could say, such as having a sleep paralysis every single day, getting into trivial troubles all the time, breaking and destroying materials that I've got to put on. But what can I do? Since I promised to stand on the stage, I had to let it be. Deciding the title first, and then waiting for something to happen, so I could be able to say something on the stage. I waited and waited and did nothing, literally nothing. A few weeks later, packed things, ideas for the brain came up in my mind that I've got an idea, I mean, loads of ideas. Just by thinking of this one sentence, ideas for the brain. Yes, I'm supposed to be the person who has extremely tremendous amounts of sense and creativity, however, my brain just suddenly decided to stop operating when the friends called pressure materializes. Again, I have wasted this precious, priceless, and valuable time and energy. Oh, or perhaps through these moments, I was able to make myself write this speech and tell it to the people in front of me right now. This could be seen as a positive effect, however, the point is, just like this, I've wasted a considerable amount of opportunities, which could support me to further enhance myself. If you miss the present, you throw away an opportunity, and with these, your most precious presents, meaning precious presents, will be squandered, and I have included a French word here in order to look a bit like an Japanese person. So add a little bit about my feelings now. Frankly speaking, I feel so proud of myself because it seems like I have delivered some good morals to you, which is now. Next, I have prepared to speak about two movies and a book relevant to the topic of presence. I know my speech goes on at times without a single connection, but I ask all of you to understand and listen to my not big but small speech. Well, I should have said this initially, but anyways. Going back to the topic, the first movie that I want to introduce is Kung Fu Panda, and I believe no one does not know this movie. Please put your hands up if you've either heard or watched this movie. Majority of it. It's a relief to see someone. Does anyone know the famous line from this movie? Or rather, does anyone can tell the famous line from this movie? Yes, please. Perfect. Yesterday is a mystery, tomorrow is a mystery, but today is a gift. That is why it is called The Present. This movie looks like an ordinary animation to the eye, however, I was remarkably inspired by this movie and realized that there is a definite need for me to keeping myself from being aversive and regard present as a present. And I hope all of you understood what I meant. Another movie that I want to give information about is called Gifted. Since I want all of you to watch this movie and enjoy it, I'm not going to tell a lot about it, but a brief narrative. The main character in this movie is a 7-year-old girl, Mary, who is a math genius. The conflict between her uncle and her grandmother arises because they want Mary to live contrary to each other, and that's why. Despite the fact that I've watched this movie several weeks ago, impressions still linger in my mind. Finally, the book that I want to talk about is called The Timekeeper by Mitchell, and he is my favorite author, and this book teaches us how precious the time is. I personally can see the link between the famous line from Kung Fu Panda and The Timekeeper. And this book is also another one that I prefer for sure. These three sources are the ones that I'm hoping for all of you to enjoy. By combining all of them and summarizing them, one sentence has been made in my mind, and it will be the last sentence I'll say. The last thing I want to deliver to you guys is present, present, present. Thank you.